people, they think too much of other people's thought in a disgusting way. Seriously. Guys, those people that you fear and you think about too much, if they come and they don't like the business, what's gonna happen to me? So those people that you are wasting your life, you know, scared talking to them, if you are broke, are they gonna feed your kids? Are they gonna pay your bills? Are they gonna take you out of jail? Or would they say, skin, haram. I feel bad for you. And they walk away.
He was a good
guy. And you have spent your life, you know, so much carefully, so much in deep caring about how they feel. Good luck. You can never live life like this. People will step over you and walk. People will step over you and walk. You can only live life sharp and bold. This is the only way. Or you will be among the followers. Or you will be among the people who have no names written anywhere. Guys, you have to be proud of what you have. You are calling someone to change his pathetic, repetitious, broke life and invite him into a business opportunity that can change his whole entire life. And think of it for a minute. That person you invite, he can be your downline, right? And your downline can make money much more than you. When he make money much more than you, will he grab his pocket and give you?
No.
You're doing him a hell of a favor. This is how you have to think. You're doing people a favor by bringing into the business. This is the confidence you have to have when you call someone. Imagine that you have a birthday party in Atmosphere restaurant. Who knows as Atmosphere? Okay, for other who doesn't know, it's the highest restaurant in the world. The highest. It's in Burj Khalifa. So imagine that you are inviting your guests to the Atmosphere restaurant. How will you call them? I don't deserve you to come. Go. Next. This is for a party that cost you 500 dirham per person. Not for something that can give them millions and thousands in their life. See how confident you are? By only inviting him to the Atmosphere party. So you're inviting him to have a party of his whole entire life. You have to be that confident, ladies and gentlemen. This is the first thing you have to think when you present or invite someone. That's why you will not shake. You will not have the phone. Please come. Let's see what are the main things to do about inviting your prospect. Invite the prospect. What is the main purpose of invitation? Listen carefully. Getting your prospect excited and curious enough to attend your business presentation without giving him or her any technical information. Please just invite. If you go to Oxford Dictionary and read what is the definition of invite, what does invite means? To invite someone. Not to explain the business over the phone to someone. So invite means is only invite. Don't explain. Get him curious, excited. Use high echoing words. That's what you need to do. That's it. So follow these rules I'm going to show you. And you'll have a powerful invitation. One, 95% of your invitation is done over the phone. Why 95%? Because if I said 100%, you know what will happen? Some people will have a roommate. At night, they will step out of the room and call and invite him, his roommate. So that's why I put 95%. So please, don't invite your roommate on the phone unless you're outside the home. Okay? So 95% of your invitation should be done over the phone. Good. Always start the call by asking the person, are you free for a moment? I have something important to discuss. Okay, before I tell you this, the purpose is this. When I want to call someone, number one is I want to drag his attention. Number two is I want to change his mood. Why dragging his attention? Because you can call up someone, hi, how you doing? And you call him and you talk with him, but he is focusing with a football match. Or he's focusing with his manager. Or he's looking at something. So he is with you on the phone, but absolutely not with you mentally. So the first thing I want is to drag his attention. It's like, Muhammad, how you doing? Excellent. Man, I've got something important to discuss. Are you free or should I call you back? Oh, wait a minute. No, go ahead. Now, what did I do? I dragged his attention. That's what I want. So first thing accomplished. I want to drag his attention. Are you free or should I call you back? No, go ahead. I'm with you. That's what I want. His attention is with me. Second question is, he might be in his job, had a big fight with a client or with his boss. So he's so negative. He is so, you know, in a bad mood. And people who are negative or in a bad mood, always, they have a mental block. They're not a good receiver. Okay? So you need to change someone's mood. The easiest way is what? Is to make him or her think of things they love. So for example, I know Muhammad, he is a caraholic. He is someone who is, you know, love cars. And he goes to off-road deserts, 4x4, like dune bashing. And I know he just bought new big tires for the car, a new suspension that cost 50,000 dirham. I would have gone, hi Muhammad, oh tell me, how was the car performance? Oh man, you should have seen it. It was like a monster. So immediately, I got him back of his bad mood. Or I can ask him, how was our pretty Lulu, like his daughter? Oh man, she looks so good. She's missing you, by the way. So all what I want him to visualize, something he likes. So once he starts visualizing something he likes, he is out of the negative mood. Now he's a good receiver. So the first purpose is done. Is I dragged his attention and I've changed his mood. So now he is ready to take what you're going to get. So this is the first purpose. 95% of the call, should the invitation must be over the phone. And this is how it should be done. Don't mention anything related to the business. Never mention anything related to our company, business, or product over the phone. Why? Two important reasons. Now, I told you, I need someone to, what is the time now?
14:38.
Okay, here. I need someone of you. Okay, two most important reasons. What is it? Now, if you are thirsty, you're in the desert, you're so much thirsty, and someone comes and walk next to you, and he has a big bottle of water, so cold, wet from outside, and he show it to you like this, what would you do? You would run to get it. Then if he walks away, you will run and follow him. He runs away, you run behind him, because he wants what you have. When you make someone curious to know what you have, you will always make him follow. Now, when you start to explain someone anything about the business, you are answering questions. You're killing curiosity. Now, what happens to people is this. Every one of us are busy anyway. Every one of us, we are using our 24 hours every day already. So we are all busy. And everyone has what we call priority. I don't know how to spell it, whatever. Yeah, it's priority list. This priority list could be, let's say, family, job, religion, things, you know, friends,
football,
five clubs, six dating, whatever it is. Like, this is a priority list. And, you know, it's even, you know, taking the garbage outside home is among the priority list. Now, what happens? When you make someone curious by exciting him and giving him those sound echoing words and get him curious, you are putting your business presentation meeting is among his top three. find time for the top three. We always can find time for the top three. So let's say your boss call you at evening and tell you tonight, and you're at home, tonight I want to meet you at 11 a.m. in my office. You will tell him I'm busy?
No.
You'll always find time. Why? Because those always among the top three priority. The top three priority are always can find time for. So when you get him so curious, okay, and you will always put it here. So you guarantee he's come. The more you explain, the more you're killing curiosity. It's like someone is thirsty, you keep giving him water, his, you know, is getting better and better, so he's not following you that hard. So number one, don't give information not to kill curiosity. Number two, because there are some people who will always compare Doobly to MLM. And we are not MLM. We are not the traditional networking. We are not selling any MLM crap. We are a total definition of network marketing. But this particular area can never ever be described over the phone. And you can never ever convince him. When anyone in the world asks me, whenever I present someone or invite him, is it MLM? I saw with full loud mouth, no, it's not. Because we are not. It's a total principle and definition. Okay? So that's why don't disclose. You will get question after question after question. You will lose him. And I was one of the top skeptical people on earth about MLM. Because I was presented in the wrong way. But if I was not invited in the right way and attended the full complete presentation, I would never be where I am. So you can have another Khaled, another Zamani, another Hamdan, another Muhammad, another one of the top leaders, another you. But you lost him because he thinks negatively. So don't disclose. Good. Third rule, fourth rule. It's not what you say, it's how you say it. Your tone of voice should always represent the importance of your subject. The tone of your voice should always represent the importance of your subject. Now, you are inviting someone for something great, a great business opportunity, an internet revolution. You know, man, you remember Groupon 6 years back? They were nothing. Now they're $6 billion business. I'm talking about someone even bigger than Groupon, man. We are tied with an international company whose Groupon, one of their partners. What's it all about? Man, I can't really even talk. It is an extreme powerful internet revolution. This company is tied up with the biggest, with Etisalat, with ADIB. Just give the high echoing word. That's it. Get him excited and he will come. And you have to use the proper tune of voice so he can hear you well. Good. Now, next step or next rule. Making an appointment must be done by giving limited options. By giving limited options. You don't tell someone, come today. He don't work for you. And you don't tell someone, when are you free? Because when you ask someone, when are you free? No one is interested to show you that he has a free life. No one is interested to tell you that he has no life. He will tell you, I have this, I have that, I have that. Saturday, I am busy with my friend. Sunday, I have to take my brother to the hospital. Monday, it's my girlfriend's dog's birthday. Tuesday, he will be busy for the rest of his life. No one is interested to you, he's free. So you tell him simply, you're free today or tomorrow. People like to choose. So you let him choose within a limited option that suits you. You made him choose within a limited option that suits you, which is already coordinated with your upline, or coordinated with the time of the mass presentation, or coordinated with the time of the existing webinar system, which is the fifth part I want to talk about. You have always to start using the existing webinar system. Existing webinar system where we have daily Arabic presentation, live, and 4 times a week English presentation in different timing to suit, you know, the Far East timing and to suit the Arab world timing. This will help you to build an international business. This will help you to even let ladies who are, you know, cannot really go out a lot because they have 4 or 5 kids and they have a day work, to help you build the business, because they can build the business from home. This webinar system is presented by the best presenters. The best presenters, they work for you. You can make every house of your team as an office. They can invite people to their house, connect the laptop to the LCD, and show a live presentation at their house. And they can take the mic and ask the presenter questions, and presenters will interact. So use this existing webinar system. And finally, if you can accept your worst fear, then nothing to fear. This is what I have started with. Maintain your posture. If I invite someone, I tell him, you're free today or tomorrow, let's say Tuesday or Wednesday. He said, no, not Tuesday, not Wednesday, I'm free on Thursday. I will tell him, okay, let's meet Thursday. I said, okay, let me get back to my appointments and I will call you back. I will wait for 10, 15 minutes, I'll call him back, I'll tell him, no, Thursday, I'm not free. Can we make it Saturday or Sunday? I will always ask him to follow my timing, because you have to maintain your posture. The moment or the time or the minute people feels that you need them is the same time they walk away. I maintain my posture. He needs me, I don't need him. This is my approach. Good. Fifth pillar, presentation day. Okay, 10 minutes to go. I don't know how I'm going to make this in 10 minutes, but we'll try our best. Fifth pillar, presentation day. Here, I'm not going to talk about the art of presentation, because this is also another separate training. What are the things or what are the skills you need to make a professional presentation? But what I'm going to discuss here, what are the things required to be done in the presentation day? The art, the ethics, the rule that you have to have in presentation day, which help you make it happen. Number one, dress smart for your success. You're inviting your people for a business opportunity, so you should look like one. You want to give the people the serious approach. Now, your friends, they used to see you with a short, with a t-shirt. Now, when you invite them with that excitement, and they come and see you looking formal, I don't mean that you are in a suit. Now, being in a suit is even better. But I mean, I think smart, casual, you know, oh, okay. What's it about? It looks something serious. So that's the first impression I'm giving him, okay? Dress smart for your success. Two, be there before your prospects. Respecting people's time will result in making them respect the importance of your business. They will feel that you are serious. You have to be before your prospect. Three, present people in places where you own the control. And this is a common mistake. Please don't present someone in his office. Please don't go to someone in his house and present him. Please don't present some people in a party. You have always to choose the proper time. You have always to choose the place where you can control. Because when you go to people's house or people's office, every minute a new client will come. The boss will walk in, phone will ring. You can never explain the business there. They will never focus. For someone to understand, he needs your focus, he needs your full attention. So you have to, and even don't go to a coffee shop that he always goes for. Because if you go to a coffee shop, he's always hanging in. Every few minutes someone will come, hi, how are you doing? Hi, how are you doing? Total distraction. Meet in a neutral place, or you choose the place. In your office, in your house, in your coffee shop, in somewhere where you can own the complete atmosphere and control. Okay? Then, identify your leader or the presenter well. The more important and successful you make your leader look like, the more attention your prospect will give. Very simple equation. People only like to listen to important, successful people. How you make your leader look like? This is exactly how your prospect will take the presentation from him. If you treat your leader like your friend, they will listen to him like how he's listening to you. They don't get things serious from you, like your close friends. So you have to edify your presenter or your upline very well. Talk about him high. Show a complete respect and talk about his achievement. So your prospect must feel that he is lucky to have the pleasure of meeting him. Because edification is not a personal thing. It's something for you. The more you edify your upline, the more you respect your upline in front of your prospect, the more you let your prospect listen and concentrate. Because people only want to listen to successful people. Those are the people that they take things seriously from and they get the whole knowledge. Five, edify or talk about your, introduce your prospect well. Most people, let's say, I'm inviting, okay, Shashi is inviting Mariam, so I present her. I'm Shashi applying. Good? Now, he said, Mariam, and just no more words. When you bring someone to your upline to present him, after you already edify, after Shashi finished edifying me to Mariam and talking highly about me, and then when I sit with them, he has to talk positively about her. He has to give me enough knowledge about her, where she works, what she do, what kind of person. So I am the presenter, know where to focus more. The more I know the prospect, the more I can tailor make the presentation to suit her. So that's extremely important. And always talk on her, she's one of the most active, positive people that I really wanted to be the first people, because I know Mariam's personality. She's one of the people who will definitely make it in our business. That's why I want her to be among my first partners. And she works here, she does that, blah, 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 blah. Excellent. That's it. That's what we want anyone to present. Don't interrupt the presenter and give full attention during the presentation. Don't interrupt the presenter and give full attention during the presentation. When the presenter starts to speak, don't open your mouth at all. Unless he asks you. Carlos, you presented your prospect, he started presenting. Just learn the art of head shaking. That's it. Whenever he says a statement, shake your head. Don't open your mouth until he asks you. Because sometimes you might say something which is totally... when you interrupt someone of his speech, when you talk, and I keep interrupting you, I am proving to the prospect that whatever you say is worthless. Yes. You are no one. And this is what you don't want your prospect to feel. You want your prospect to give full attention. Interrupting someone's statement is disrespecting his statement. So don't interrupt your upline statement unless he asks you to do so. This is what we have to do in the presentation day. Now, we finish the presentation. Everything works fine. The presenter had made a perfect presentation and he answered your prospect questions. Closing the deal. Most of the people would want someone they trust to help them taking the decision, especially after being introduced to our great business, which is something very new to them, or they used to be very skeptical about. And this is the most important moment. This is the most important moment where your people need your help. They have listened to the presentation. They are happy. They're excited. They're confused. They're skeptical. This is the moment when you have to get in and support him. What should I do after the presentation? Simple. Follow these rules and you'll have a very effective method. One, after the presentation is done, thank your presenter for his time and appreciate it. And then what you do? Stay with your prospect alone. Very important. After the presentation is finished and you thank your leader, you take your prospect and you sit aside in another table. Because there are some questions that he might feel shy to ask the presenter. but he'll feel free to talk to you. So you really want to know what's inside him. So you have to be alone with him after the presentation. And be around the leader. Because sometimes he might ask you a question you cannot handle. But when he's your leader around, he can help you handle those questions. Two, answer all his questions in a positive way. And if you don't have an answer to a certain questions, immediately ask your leader, ask your upline. Some people will feel shy to go and ask or say, no, I want to answer. No, it's even better. Even sometimes when you know the answer, go and ask the upline. Let your prospect feel that it's a support business. That you don't know everything yet and you're making money. So good, I can do the same. You will give him a relief. Let him feel that, oh, it's a support. Even if I don't know something, I can still start and ask my upline. Good. So answer all his questions. If you don't know the answer, immediately go and ask your upline. Three, always ask questions. Take your success, talk about your success experience and what type of support you got from the leaders and from the Diamonds team. Again, people, they must know that they are not going to build alone. This is their worst fear. Can I do it? And maybe I'll fail. Is it going to work for me? By telling him that we are one team, that we work with each other, support each other, I'll show you what I have done, then you can apply it to you. That will give him the trust to do it. Four. Okay, this one I like so much. Always ask a question that has a positive answer. Always ask them question that ends with yes. Don't tell him, what do you think about the opportunity? I don't like it. What do you think about the business? I don't like it. Do you like the business or not? No, I don't. I don't ask questions that have two answers. Tell him, what is the most thing you like about the business? What is the most thing you like? So when he asks this question, see, people are programmed to be negative. Now always, the no word is at the just edge of their tongue. Why? Because the no will protect them for some time to think or to stay away. So when they go out of the presentation, they're always preparing a no for you. They might like everything, but they say, okay, the presenter tie looks ugly. I'm not interested. They will always have a no. The PowerPoint presentation, the top left corner was not clear. So he's not using a good PowerPoint version. So he's broke. So I don't believe he makes money. They will find an excuse. They will always say no before you even start. This is the programmed. Even if they like it, they just want to buy some time. So what I say, I don't allow them to say no. I will not let them think negatively. I will let them think positively. When I ask them, what is the most thing you like? I force them to think of all the things he likes to pick the best one. So, the money part was the best, and I talked about the money. The cash part is the best. I give him more about the cash part. So always ask a question. For example, I'm not going to tell him, do you think that he will join? As if you're begging him. So you're planning to go for PPA or TM? It's over. Well, you know what I think? I don't think you're going for TM, right? PPA is the best choice. So I have deleted the possibility that he might say no. I don't think you're going for TM. PPA is a no-brainer. You know, I'm not going to even give him a chance to think about those things. So always ask a question that has a yes answer. Good. We'll go to the be very positive and make him feel that you will support him and work with him as a team. Always share positive stories, your experience, your support that you got from your team, etc., etc. And finally, explain to him the importance of time and advise him not to talk to his people about. Okay. In this point, what happens? Now, 95% of people will not sign up on the same day. Okay? They need to like our kabbayans, what they say, I need to sleep over it. I don't know what does that mean, if someone tell you, I need to sleep over it. He will take the presentation under his pillow and sleep and wake up. I don't know. But they always, I need to sleep over it, or let me think about it, or let me ask my wife, let me ask my husband, whatever, okay? So this is what happens to 95% of those people. So that's why we need the follow-up, which we're going to have in a different training. But at the end, what you should do, you must explain for him the importance of time. You must explain for him the importance of time and what is the benefit of the first mover advantage if he signed up before. And then ask him not to explain to anyone. And tell him you have the right to ask anyone. But if you want to ask them when we are with you. And give them a simple example. Tell him if you're driving home tonight. If you're driving home tonight and you've listened to the best song from the best singer you ever loved. It was a 1 minute song or 2 minute song. Now after 2 hours, if I'll play for you the music, can you repeat the same song perfectly?
No.
Absolutely not. So what about a half hour presentation? You can never deliver the presentation in the same way. Accordingly, you can never get your people to the same excitement level. So you will lose them. So please, just don't discuss with anyone. And if you want to ask anyone, ask them when we are with you. We will do the presentation. And at that time, pick from him an appointment, maximum within 48 hours. Very important, before he walks away, take from him an appointment. Okay, when we're planning to meet, tomorrow or the day after? He's like, yeah, I think I'll be ready within 2 days. Good. I'll call you tomorrow, 5 p.m. to confirm. You need that time for the follow-up, which I'm going to talk about in the next training. So this is the closing with strategy. In this way, you have closed the gaps. You're increasing your sign-up possibility. So now, this is the sixth part. I'll send you the link, follow-up and handling reflection. Okay. This is the link, the last part, I think you'll link for it. But, now, what we have heard, I've heard a system, okay, that starts within you, how to convert yourself to a believer, and we've seen so many examples, how when someone believes can make things happen. Then, I know what I should do first is to put my commitment, what is the time I need to put in the business, build my capital of the prospect list, treat the prospect list, which is my capital, properly, in the good invitation way, and by starting from hot, warm, cold, and then when inviting them for my upline to present them, or for a mass presentation, or for the webinar, I know what should I do in the presentation day, and what are the behaviors to be followed, and after the presentation, now I know what should happen. Now, you have done all of that, and you know it, it's very clear. The next step is what? I told you how can every one of you make a $20,000. Very simple. How that is possible? Now, duplicate. Whatever you've learned and apply, you must teach your team. Why? Let me show you why, and I love mathematics, because number does not lie. Duplicate the getting started training. Teach others. What will happen? Follow this training system and teach them to teach others to do the same. This is your road to success with your Duply business. Why is it your road to success? Let's talk about some numbers. Results of duplication. Who wants to start earning $20,000 a month? You are a billionaire? Good. Now, you can... We can retire on $20,000 a month, right?
Yes.
Like $80,000 per month, it's good to retire.
It's amazing.
It's amazing, yes. See, he's an engineer and he's saying that, by the way. I mentioned because I know him. We're all engineers. Good. $80,000, that's so amazing, right? Now, how can I make that possible? From duplication. Now, all what I want is $20,000 a month, right? Minimum. To be financially free. To achieve that, you need Now we know I have to divide that by $40 because the step value is how much? $40. So $20,000 divided by 40 is equal 500 steps, right? And I know one PPA can make for me 6 steps on one time because you have a bigger volume. So that means I need 500 steps per month, 125 steps per week. Let's convert that to number. So that means I need 100 team members to sign up weekly on each site. So I need every week 100 small package to sign up left and right. Or I only need 20 left, 20 right from the big package, which all we are building here in UAE. Good? So I want to assume the worst. I want to assume that I need an average, let's say, I need 150 people. I don't know, see, you need 100 people left, 100 people right. How much? 200. So I will assume that only you need 150. Because let's say 10% of your sign up are PPA and 90% are the small package. That 10% will make you more than 100 steps. So with another 150 TM, so you are, all what you need to do is 150 sign up per week. So now, to achieve $20,000 per month, you need 150 sign up per week. 90% TM, 10% PPA. Now, I want to put an acceptance rule. I will say, alhamdulillah and doubly, among the 18 years experience, I've never seen any company that has higher conversion than Dupli. In our Dupli business, we have up to 80 to 90% conversion. Like out of 10, 8 to 9 says yes. But I want to be conservative and I want to say 50%. So out of 10, only 5 says yes. Good? So let's say 50% is our acceptance percentage. So if I want 150 people to sign up every day, that means I have to present how many? 300 people, so I can have 150 per week. So I can make $20,000. So if I want to present 300 people per week, that means I have to present how many every day? 45 people every day to make the $20,000. So, if you're not that type of people who are patient enough to teach your team to duplicate your work, good luck. You need 45 presentations every single day to achieve $20,000, which is almost non-doable. But, if I am patient enough to train my team to duplicate my work, what will happen? But if you sign up only 3, train them and get 3 each, and work with them to get 3 each, by only following a simple training process, you will have 50 prospects in your team. Now those 50 persons, if every one of them only make 1 presentation a day, only 1 presentation a day, you will have almost 300 presentations a week. And you will have the same money, the $20,000. So now think of it. 45 presentations that you have to do alone versus 1 presentation. Which one is doable?
One.
Anyone can present once a day, 5 days a week. Anyone can invite 1 prospect to the presentation. Anyone can invite 1 prospect to the webinar once a day. Only you need to have 50 people in your team. Sign up 3, train them to get 3, train them to get 3, and have 50. Now you work with the 50, all what they have to do is to present 1 a day. In this way, you can make the $20,000. This is the potential of duplication. So all what you need to do, ladies and gentlemen, is teach your people to do the same. And from now on, we knew how we can go over excuses. Because the last thing I want to tell you is this. All distraction and excuses in life are equal. I don't have time, I don't have money, my upline is moral, my downline is moral, no one is listening to me, I don't have... All these are excuses. All these are distractions. Excuses and distractions in life are equal. But please notice, you can only make money or make excuses. You can never make both. So choose. Follow the system, apply it and make money, or spend the rest of your life making excuses. Thanks a lot for your time. God bless you all.
We'll go for the presentation after 10 minutes.
Or yes, okay. All right. So we can ask the prospect to get them. Thank you.